Good morning, traders. Welcome to our weekly analysis. Today, July the 12th, it's a pleasure to review the markets. We're going to check the euro, we're going to check the dollar index, we're going to check the S&P and oil. Before we start, I want you to sign up for our free webinar this week on elliottwavestreet.com/webinar. You are going to get access to this free course with the power of volume profile and Elliott Wave in markets. We're going to meet on July the 14th at 5 p.m. EST, same on July the 15th, and we're going to talk about from scratch how to use volume profile, and the next class, we're going to mix volume profile with Elliott Wave to find the best entries. Reserve your spot right now, just need to fill up the form, and that's it. All right, so let's talk about the live markets, what we are seeing today. Here we have the euro, and we are seeing the price on the euro going sideways. However, before this little pause on the bearish trend, we have a big move down. My first short entry was here, and the second one was here. Fantastic entries, right? I share with my clients when I trigger the trades, and I have a Telegram channel for the membership in the membership where you can sign up. And look here, May the 26th was my first sell stop at the 122.34. That was entry number one. And entry number two, June the 1st, was the second entry at the retrace. I booked some profits during the road, and I'll still have part of that trade active. Now, my plan is to have the price coming here to the below the 117 area. I'm going to book full profits at this area, and I want to start getting ready to buy the euro somewhere here once we have a signal to go back to the previous high. So we are at the last part of the movement. Usually is the accumulation cycle where the institutional traders are going to start buying, and this could be choppy. You know, it's going to be a choppy ride at the last stage of this move. On lower time frames, we can take advantage of this opportunity of the next leg down. And the big question for this week is if wave B already ended, if wave B is done or not. Because if the B wave is done, we can expect a strong move down. And if the B wave is active, we can expect, first of all, a move up. So in order to decide which one is going to happen, we can use the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sequence. If we have the 5-wave sequence, we don't have it yet, then I'm going to sell during wave 2. And on the other hand, if the price here moves higher, I'm going to sell it here at the market top. So I'm looking for a short trade on the euro this week. Similar is on the dollar. We can see on the dollar the price doing exactly the same thing. So far we have the 3-wave sequence. So we have a 3-wave sequence here. If we have the completion for 4-5, fantastic. If we have only the 3-wave sequence, then a price can make a lower low, right? So it's the same thing, looking to buy the dollar this week, and now waiting for the validation. Well, the S&P is going up. I believe we are going to have new record highs this week. We're having new record highs this week. And I'm looking for the 4,500 area as the next important level. So here I'm looking for a breakout of this area, a retrace for two, and we will see if the slope of the move is like this. That would be fantastic. I have been accumulating S&P positions. Or if it's going to be more choppy, you know, more like this. Probably, you know, the S&P really likes to go slowly, more choppy, like this cycle, and eventually does a corrective wave and then continues. So has been working fantastic, the wave count, and I'm going to continue with the bullish view. Oil. Be extremely careful with oil, because with oil, market seems to be doing the last leg up. So ideally, we should have the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sequence and then start looking for short trades to sell at the market top. That's what I'm planning to do, to start selling. We already have some sellers, commercial sellers, institutional sellers coming into the market. So this is going to be a discount to sell at the best price possible. So let's see if we have a hard high. It's not a buy trade. You know, be extremely careful because the market can collapse before making the hard high. So it's more focusing on finding the top of the market on oil rather than riding the last leg, because with all these sellers that we have on the left, the market can start going lower before. So it's too risky to follow this possible last leg up. Fantastic traders. If you like to learn more about our systems, learn more about Elliott Wave and volume profile, please visit ElliottWaveStreet.com/webinar. I'm having this free fantastic webinar this week talking about a volume profile from scratch. It's a powerful tool. You're not going to see these techniques that how I teach it anywhere, and it's free. So join us and Elliott Wave in markets. You are going to receive the recording of the event. If you can't assist, it's going to be a Zoom webinar, and you are going to learn a lot about how to use these great tools. Please have a fantastic trading week. I'll see you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.